first time I saw her was in fall of 1956, the band room at Missoula County High School. And we were watching all the freshmen walk into band practice during the summer. And I saw this brunette come in with a ponytail through the door with her horn, French horn in hand. And that's the very first time I laid eyes on her.
He was adventuresome. And he wasn't the cowboy that I had planned on, but boy, he—I don't know. There was just—it was just—he was just the one. Our first date was after a football game, and I was very, you know, kind of in awe of him because he was a senior and I was a freshman.
Went to Brownies, In-N-Out, bought her a hamburger.
First kiss too. First date.
Ooh,
scary.
I should have ran.
My name is Patricia Helen Bates.
And my name is Roy O. Bates Jr., and this is my life.
Nothing on earth. I was named Patricia because I was born on St. Patrick's Day on March 17, 1941, in Missoula, Montana. My mother was short, fairly short, I'd say about barely 5 foot. She had big brown eyes and beautiful, beautiful hair, a wonderful smile. And she was really a very, very nice looking woman. It's very low key, very very easygoing. She taught me a lot of things. She taught me how to cook and how to sew. She was very, very gracious in her church work. She was always out to help the downtrodden and the people that were in need of support. And she was very, very talented. My mother's full name is Margaret Ruth Barnett, and she was born in Puyallup, Washington. My dad saw my mother. She was playing the horn, the trumpet, in the Salvation Army band, and at that time they wore little bonnets and their uniforms, and he noticed her right away as a beautiful girl, and he did everything he could to get into the band, which he ended up carrying a flag so he could be in the band. My father's full name is John Woodrow Shoemaker. My father is an extremely handsome man. He always was. He is tall and very, very sharp looking fellow, and always has been. He still is today at 89. He is extremely supportive. I ended up working or going to school and interest in music, and he made sure that I got to try every instrument that was out there, and I ended up with a French horn and earned a scholarship to the university with my music. I'm the oldest in the family. I have two brothers. My younger brother, William Barnett Shoemaker, he was a handsome guy. He was just real quiet and very reserved. He actually died of leukemia in his late 40s, early 50s. And my brother Roger, who is the baby of the family, who's 10 years younger than I am. He is a long-haul truck driver. Out of Texas, and he goes all over the United States with his big semis. I really loved Missoula. That is the place to grow up. It's at the heart of the Rocky Mountains. It's beautiful, four seasons. It was a time period where we didn't lock our doors. We didn't even know about crime. We didn't even think about those things. I'm sure they were there, but not like they are today. We lived in several different places, I would say maybe five. We lived on a farm, which I loved. We had pigs and horses and chickens, and I loved the farm life. I loved ranch life, and that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to grow up and marry someone that had a big ranch. And at 1 year, I was a rodeo queen. Not that I rode in the rodeo, but we had a pageant. And that was a fun thing. And I always liked to hang around the exhibits with the horses and the animals to see, you know, to meet the cowboys and get to know them. And then my life completely changed from that point. You know, the best memories of my school years were excellent teachers, my music. I was a musician and I enjoyed playing my French horn. I went to college after high school and I went to school from 8 o'clock in the morning till 6 o'clock at night because I took one credit music courses, plus I was in the band and I was had to take the core courses. And I dated my husband who was in ROTC and finishing up his business degree at Montana State University.
Named after my father, who was Roy Sr., I was born on October 21st, 1938, in Missoula, Montana. My mother's full name was Vera Payne. She was born in Tremont, Utah, 1905, October 11th. Mom was a very quiet person, and she wore the pants. And she knew it was unfortunate to this day that I think about my mother's opportunities, because she lived without a formal education, maybe the fifth grade at the most, but she could have gone a long ways had she been given the opportunity. She was number 8 of 12 children, nice big Mormon family in Utah. And I can remember her telling me stories about when she was a young girl, her and her sisters, working on the dry farms for her dad, and a couple of sisters would get up and go up and work on the little ranch house. It was only used during the summer, during the thrashing season. And there was a little contest between all the families in Utah at that time about who provided the best meals for the thrashing crews. And my mother and her sisters were really, really good cooks. Even till the day she died, she was well known for her ability to make breads, rolls, cinnamon rolls. My father got a good deal when he met my mother. My mother was the gardener, and she could make things grow out of Montana rocks that I still to this day can't believe how many rocks there are in the soil in Montana. My father's full name was Roy Orman Bates, Sr. His personality was very quiet. My father came from 8 kids. He was number 4. He was raised by his older sisters, Florence Anfinson and Millie. That's all my father had, was his brothers and sisters. During the war, my dad was a cook for the Forest Service in what's called a remount station. In those days, we didn't have helicopters and they didn't have airplanes. And you fought forest fires by men, crews with pack animals, mules and horses. And the 9 Mile Remount Station was one of the bigger ones in the Northwest. And they would he would cook for these crews of men as they come in and go out. And I can remember as a child going one time with him out there, and it was my very first shower in life. And I can remember that was a traumatic experience to me. He got laid off from the Forest Service, and I think it was about 1946 or 47, and he bought a little tractor called a Gibson, and he spent that summer plowing, spring and summer, plowing little gardens throughout the town, and he'd take me with him, and I'd kind of help him, and that's what I learned, how to drive a tractor on that little Gibson tractor. He did his best, and he, from what his background, he did very good, I guess. And I can remember my mother would bring him out and make him work in the yard. He was a good dad. We enjoyed it. I have one sister, Barbara Joyce Bates Warboys. She married a young man from Canada in school. Barbara's and I grew up. We were not real close. The age difference, I guess. I was a big, mean brother, And we'd tease her, and I'd tease her unmercifully. But I do remember later on in school, she knew how to spell, and of course my spelling was very bad. But she would take and she'd type up my papers for me. I'd have been a much better student with spell check. Fortunately, she was my spell check, so that was my little sister. Family vacations, I can remember, again, my father and my uncle, Deck, took me fishing one time, which I can remember. It's one of the few times I can remember being with my father. And I can remember him making coffee, where you put the coffee grounds in an old sock and throw them in the bottom of the coffee pot. And I can remember the smells that morning. And then when we caught a trout out of the river that was going by, they cleaned it on the spot, put it in the frying pan. We had that for breakfast. Those two smells I will never forget. When I was a young boy, I loved model airplanes. I'd spend hours building down in the basement. My world was very small. And Missoula at the time was a very small town. And we lived in the first house till just after the World War II. A guy just down the street built a theater. And in those days, there were the big major chains, Fox, and United Artists. And this guy was an independent. He bought his own films from whoever would sell it to him, and he ran his family theater. Well, I went to work for him setting the marquee and cleaning up at night after the show was over. Well, then his son was about 6-7 years older than I was, and decided he wanted a few nights off. So he taught me how to be a projectionist. And every night I was in the theater, or almost every night, working. It wasn't, you know, the guy was, I guess he gave me many of the values I have in life, because he was so tight that a penny squealed when it came out of his pocket. So I did that from all the way from grade school through high school and into college. And there's not much in the theater business that I didn't learn, including the buying or the selling of the tickets, cleaning the theater, setting the marquee, projectionist, buying the movies from the producers, and arguing with them. And that's what I learned in life, to negotiate, argue with the salesmen as they come by trying to sell you a movie. And when you're working on a shoestring, you don't buy the first runs. You know, you're getting the second ones or third ones as they've been through a town.